Let me tell you what you see on TV. What you see on TV are some people who are going in single file across the river, and they're being led by a cartel member. And the reason why they're going single file is because the cartel is trying to lead them to land that is owned, controlled, or operated by the federal government. Because what the cartels know is if they get the people they're smuggling across the border to that land that's owned or controlled or operated by the federal government, they will have their paperwork processed, and then they will be set free to roam about the United States of America. And it's the Border Patrol filling out that paperwork. Listen, about 90% of the Border Patrol, they're just processing paperwork. They're not patrolling the border. And what Border Patrol does after they process the papers, they dump these people off into small little towns on the border like Eagle Pass or Del Rio or some others. Towns that have no ability whatsoever to be able to deal with the hundreds, if not thousands, of people who have been dropped off in their communities. And so when I was at this meeting back in April, I said, listen, I'm going to help you out. Because next week, the following week, I am going to start busing them to Washington, D.C. So why Washington, D.C.? Come on. Listen, you know I'm a very thoughtful governor. I think two reasons. Washington, D.C. is a self-declared sanctuary city. They told the country, they told the world, come here. If you're in the country illegally, they will take care of you. And until they were put to the test. Yeah. So they talk real big. They try to say, oh, you people down south, you're supposed to do what we're telling you to do. But by God, when they have to live up to it themselves, they start crying like babies. And have you noticed that the location in Washington, D.C., where we're dropping them off, has changed recently? What happened is Kamala Harris was in Texas, and she was saying how there was no problem at the border. She said that the border was secure, like everybody else in the Biden administration. So I felt a calling to I felt a calling to be educational about it. And that's why they're now being dropped off at the residence of the Vice President of the United States of America. So we were sending them only to Washington, D.C. And out of nowhere, this Mayor Adams guy from New York City started criticizing me for dropping them off in New York, which we were not doing. And we showed the paperwork to the press and to the public that we were sending them only to Washington, D.C. But that did not stop the New York mayor from continuing to criticize me for sending them to New York City. And so, you know what? I got to thinking, if I'm going to get the criticism, I'm going to get the credit. And did you see it was like last week or the week before what the mayor of New York is asking for? He says in order to take care of, it's something like 25,000 migrants. Like, so is this like an average week for us? But he says in order to take care of them, he needs $1 billion. To deal with that. Let me tell you something. If he gets $1 billion, Texas deserves $1 trillion.